We're doing a tasty menu from the French Laundry Cookbook, and we're breaking down the techniques and insight that Chef Keller talks about. This book changed the way I think about cooking, and I think I'll do the same for you. Let's make some cornets.
To make the cornets, whisk 4 ounces of softened butter until it resembles mayonnaise. Then, in a separate bowl, mix together 68 grams of flour, 18 grams of sugar, and 2 grams of salt. Using a spatula, mix 2 large egg whites into the dry mix until fully incorporated.
Whisk in the butter a third at a time until smooth. Then, place the batter into a container.
To make the stencil, we're gonna use a deli lid. Start by cutting a tab. Then go around and separate the support columns. Cut around the rim of the lid, being sure not to cut off the tab.
Remove the rim and trim off any excess plastic.
Then draw a 4-inch circle in the middle. I use my largest ring mold. Carefully cut the trace circle. Take your time. If you do it right, you'll only have to do it once. Last, I trimmed up the tab. Place the stencil on a silk pad and use the back of an offset spatula to spread the batter evenly over the stencil. Remove any excess batter with the offset. Then sprinkle with black sesame seeds and place into a 400 degrees Fahrenheit, 204 degrees Celsius oven. The recipe says to bake for 4 to 6 minutes or until set, but I found that by baking 2 to 3 minutes or until they start to ripple was better. They're not as hot and easier to roll. Place the sheet tray on the door. This will help keep them pliable. Flip the cornets over and use a cornet mold. The ones that I use, as well as the full recipe, are linked in the description. If you're right-handed like me, you will want to use the pointed end to the left. Fold the bottom of the cornet up and over the mold. Then roll the mold up, being sure to keep it tight. Be sure to keep the cornets on the sheet tray. Then line all the cornets seam side down. Bake for additional 3 to 4 minutes to set the seam. We are looking for GBD, golden brown and delicious. If they are uneven in color, stand them up on the round end and continue to bake until GBD. Pull the golden brown ones to prevent them from burning. Let them cool on the mold for 30 seconds. Then remove them from the mold and place them on a paper towel to absorb any excess butter. Before starting the next batch, wait until the sheet trays cool down and wipe away any excess batter.
If your cornets are too thick or too thin, adjust the next batch. Part of being a good cook is being observant, making the food better the next time. Chances are, your first cornets are gonna be the ugliest.
For the salmon tartare, remove any skin on your salmon by running a sharp knife between the flesh and the skin. Finely mince the 4 ounces of salmon, preferably salmon bellies, then transfer into a bowl. Do not use a food processor, as this will ruin the texture of the fish. Mix with 5 grams extra virgin olive oil, 5 grams lemon oil. Amazon messed up, so I added lemon zest, but the oil I ordered is in the description. 5 grams minced chives, 2 grams minced shallots with kosher salt and white pepper to taste. Cover and place in the fridge for a minimum of 30 minutes, up to 12 hours.
One of the techniques that Chef Keller talks about in the book is salt, pepper, and vinegar. The ability to season properly, although basic, is very challenging to master. It took me going through culinary school and working in a Michelin star restaurant to fully understand. When tasting your food, think about whether or not a little bit more salt will improve it. If you can taste the salt though, it's too much. In the book, he recommends using Daikin Crystal kosher salt, which is what I prefer too, because of the salt size. For finishing salt, he talks about using fleur de sel, which means flower of the salt, and sel gris, which means gray salt. Both of them add nice texture to a finished dish. For pepper, he mentions that it's important to use, but often it's overused, and that white pepper is used for appearances when you don't want to see black specks. Last, vinegar and acids as a whole can really elevate a dish. Just be sure to add acid before you add salt. Acids will enhance flavors, needing less salt.
For the sweet onion cream, place 10 grams of finely minced red onion in a strainer to rinse for a couple of seconds. Dry them off between a paper towel. In a small bowl, whip 135 grams of creme fraiche to soft peaks, 30 to 60 seconds. Fold in the onions and season to taste with kosher salt and white pepper. Place the creme into a piping bag and refrigerate until ready to serve. Fill the top half of the cornet with a sweet red onion creme fraiche. Spoon on the salmon tartare to create a dome. It should resemble an ice cream cone. Finish with a chive tip. If you want to serve these at a party, the easiest way is to fill a bowl with black sesame seeds or rock salt and place the filled cones in them.
I love how playful this canapé is. It just goes to show you that fine dining can be fun. And it tastes amazing. If you enjoyed this recipe, you gotta check out this first course next.